I think I just go right back to
standing for prayer. Father, we are so grateful for this day when we can come together and join this man and this woman in the holy estate of matrimony, knowing that your blessings will be upon them. You said that it's good, Lord, that a man find a wife. And so this afternoon, we ask that your hand be upon Casey and Brittany, as they are joined together in your name, and it's in your name we pray. Amen. You may be seated. We're gathered today to witness and celebrate the marriage of Casey Strobin and Brittany Thompson. Who gives this woman to be married to this man? How beautiful to see two people pledge themselves to each other in marriage. We frequently think of marriage as being built on a foundation of love, and indeed love is important, but the primary foundation of a Christian marriage is commitment, first to the Lord Jesus Christ, and then to each other. And since we hold the Bible as God's only authoritative written word, let us consider what it has to teach us about marriage. In Genesis, we read, "The Lord God said, it is not good for the man to be alone. I will make a suitable helper for him." And he made Eve from Adam's rib. Proverbs said, "He who finds a wife finds what is good and receives favor from the Lord." Significantly, the Bible tells us that Jesus performed his first miracle at a wedding celebration. His presence is also recognized at this wedding here today. The Gospels record Jesus quoting the declaration in Genesis that a man should leave his father and mother and unite with his wife, and the two will become one flesh. The writer of the Hebrews said marriage should be honored by all and the marriage bed kept pure. In addition, the Bible gives clear instructions to the husband and wife. In the fifth chapter of his letter to the Ephesians, Paul wrote this: "Husbands, love your wives just as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her. And then, each one of you must also love your wife as he loves himself." Then to the wife, Paul writes, "Wives, submit to your husbands as to the Lord, for the husband is the head of the wife as Christ is the head of the church." The Bible clearly teaches us that marriage is to be a permanent relationship of one man and one woman, freely and totally committed to each other for life. The Bible does not change to fit the passing fancy of our culture or any local custom, and these responsibilities are also changeless. Now, the world has the idea that marriage is simply a legal contract, and we're not here today to make light of that, but at the same time, marriage is a spiritual contract. When the words of faith are spoken according to the Word of God between two born-again believers, the power of God goes into operation. There's an actual miracle that takes place when the faith of two people are released in God's power. God honors their faith and brings them into union together. The world has many concepts of love, but listen as I read from 1 Corinthians 13th chapter. It says, love is patient and kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It is not rude. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no records of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices in truth. It always protects. It always trusts. It always hopes. It always preserves. Love never fails. If we would walk our lives after God's love, we would never fail in our relationship to one another. So I charge you both, walk ye in this love. Upon receiving Jesus Christ as your Savior, a miracle took place in your lives. You became what Jesus called born again. This means that God's Spirit came alive in you and began from that day to change you into the image of Christ. 1 Corinthians 2:13 tells us that it is by the Spirit that we are all baptized into one body, and that that body is Christ. So by the power of the Spirit of God, we become one with Him. I want you to understand that if you rightly discern the body of Christ, then you can rightly discern what takes place in marriage. Your spirits are joined together and have become one flesh. For this cause, the Bible says, shall a man leave his father and mother, and shall cleave to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. So are the two of you this day, joined together as one by the power and the Spirit of God. A Christian marriage is most serious because it will bind you together for life in a relationship so close and so intimate that the two of you will become one. Before you lies a future with its hopes, with its disappointments, with its successes, and with its failures, its pleasures, its pains, its joys, and its sorrows. These elements are mingled in every life and are to be expected. But for Christians, they are not there to be received with resignation, but with hope and joy in all the spiritual gifts God's Spirit promises us. Casey, do you come here freely to take Brittany as your wife according to the commandments of God in holy marriage?
I do.
And Brittany, do you come here freely today to take Casey as your husband according to the commandments of God in holy marriage? And signifying your intent, I'm going to ask you to join your right hands. And Casey, I want you to repeat these vows after me. I, Casey, take you, Brittany, to be my wedded wife. From this day forward, my purpose will be to encourage your heart, to unite with you in love, to offer you complete understanding, that our marriage may be full of the riches and the wisdom of God. I will keep you and cherish you as bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh until death parts us. In the name of the Father and of the Son and the Holy Ghost. Brittany, now holding by his right hand this man that you brought before God in his company, repeat after me. I, Brittany, take you, Casey, to be my wedded husband. From this day forward, my purpose will be to encourage your heart, to unite with you in love, to offer you complete understanding, that our marriage may be full of the riches and the wisdom of God. I will be bone of your bone, flesh of your flesh, until death parts us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. You brought some rings. Let's pray. Eternal God, bless these rings that Brittany and Casey bring, that as they wear them, they will be reminded of their faith in you and their promises to each other. Let these rings be a symbol of a deep and unending life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. I want you to take this ring and place it on your third finger, your right's left hand. Repeat after me. Say, Brittany, this ring is a sign of my love and my faithfulness. And I give it to you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. And you take this ring, place it on the third finger, on his left hand, and say, Casey, this ring is a sign of my love and my faithfulness. And I give it to you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Casey and Brittany, today you have agreed to share the rest of your lives together as a married couple. But long before today, your parents provided you with a foundation of love and caring which has brought you to this point today. At this time, I would like to invite the mothers of the bride and groom who are going to come forward, and they're going to pour the first layers of sand, which will represent the bases upon which you two will build your lives. Would you come? Separated and poured again into individual containers, so will your marriage be. The two of you shall be one forever. Casey, since you and Brittany have made these vows before God and these people, by the authority invested in me as a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ through the assemblies of God, and according to the laws of the state of Michigan, I now pronounce that you are husband and wife. You may kiss your bride. What therefore God has joined together, let no man put asunder. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it becomes my pleasure to introduce to you, for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Casey Strobes.